Very good evening, dear students. As you all know that we have already completed a half of hereditary and progeny. So let us complete the rest of it. If you have any doubts, as I've told you, to reach me. So I haven't received any message about this. So I think that it's quite clear to you all. So let's move further. So we were talking about how Mendel has selected a pea plant, and the two factors which he has taken was the color of the pea. So he has capital Y he has used for yellow color and small y for green color. So he has selected, carefully chose a plant that did not produce a mixed result. For example, yellow and green, both pure breeds. He took pure yellow and pure green, and he has used the symbol small y for pure green and capital Y for pure yellow. And when these two peas were crossbred, then you know what was the resultant. The resultant peas that we finally got were, during this reproduction, each parent is taken to form a new pair of progeny. And these pair of progeny were having a dominant yellow. All were yellow in color. Okay. And they were having recessive green. So one of these dominant and other is mixed together. The trait expressed in first generation, F1 generation, was called dominant trait, because all the peas were colored, and they were not pure. They're not pure yellow. And thus what he did is he used these first generation pea again to crossbreed and check the result. You just understand the difference between phenotype and genotype. Phenotype means appearance. You can see them as yellow in color, but you don't know their genotype. You are only seeing its appearance. So appearance are all yellow, because it shows only dominant yellow color. Whereas recessive green color is not seen there. Then thus we can say that this was in the first generation, the breed were not pure. The first generation progeny which we got were not pure. So F1 generation, we observed that 75% are yellow seeds producing pea plants and 25% are green ones. So we saw yellow phenotype as dominant in the ratio of 3:1. But these yellow which you see, we don't know whether they are pure or what is their genotype. Let us see their genotype. So what we have done is we have taken capital Y and small y, that was one where yellow and green pure breed. And then we have seen that in this genotype in the F2 generation, it is in the ratio of 1:2:1. So we found one pure breed green and one pure yellow and two, mixed ones. Two were not pure, where though yellow was the dominant phenotype, but the genotype was not there. So the YY peas with on self-pollination gave only yellow peas. This was explained with the experimentation. And the YY and small y capital Y peas on self-pollination gave about 75% yellow peas and about 25% green peas. This situation is same as step two, and the ratio was same 3:1. So phenotype is 3:1, whereas genotype was 1:2:1. The green peas that contains YY factor responsible for different properties when two pairs of contrasting characters are taken into consideration. Color of the peas, yellow and green, symbiotically indicate as capital Y and small y, and its shapes were round and wrinkled. We have seen that one was round and the other were wrinkled. Then now we have taken RR. R is for round and small r was used for wrinkle. So now two characters he has crossbred. One he has taken the color and other is the shape of the pea. So all pea seeds that were yellow and round, each pea have now the factors capital Y, small y, capital R and small r. Since yellow color and round seeds, yellow, round, yellow, green and wrinkled. So all the pea seeds will be round and yellow. And in F2 generation, what did we find? The phenotype and the genotype ratio is round and yellow were dominant over green and wrinkled. That was the phenotypic ratio. That is again 3:1. Whereas the genotypic ratio was law of independent assortment. According to the law of independent assortment, the inheritance of more than one pair of characters, the factors of each pair of characters assorts independently. And among a pair of alleles, for a character, only one expresses itself in the first generation as one of the allele is dominant over the other allele. So that is what we have observed in the first generation. Then every individual possesses a pair of alleles for any particular trait, and that each parent passes a randomly selected copy of only one of these to its offsprings. So this was very clearly seen that only one character was shown by the offsprings. To understand that, Mendeleev has used activity. So let us do that activity based upon the Mendelian's principles and see what happens. So what are we taking is 3 centimeter length and 1 centimeter chart pieces. We are taking 6.2 centimeter length, 1 centimeter breadth chart pieces and 16 red buttons, 16 white buttons, 16 e-chart, scale, sketch pen, pencil and 2 bags. Please do this activity at home. Then you will be able to understand this genotypic and phenotypic ratio very easily. Now what you are doing is you are going to prepare a chart of 4x4 box along with the number symbol as shown in the figure. So now the monohybrid cross is starting with the hybrid parents. To start with, take 1, 2, or 3, 4. In case you start with 1, 2, you remember what is monohybrid and dihybrid. In monohybrid, in the sense capital Y and small y is monohybrid. In that, only color was considered. Okay, so let us start only with one characteristics and see the results. So in this game, what are we doing? We pick all the 16 long and short pieces and prepare such pairs in each of which you have a long and short piece. Okay, and which you are going to put it into the bags. You take 2 separate bags. And what are we going to do is we are picking all 16 long and short pieces and prepare such pairs in each of which we have you have long and short pieces. Then what are we going to do? So what are you going to do is you are going to do this activity which is given in your book. And then you are going to come and tell me what was your genotype and phenotype. Okay, this activity was very clearly given in your textbooks. So read it. It's a very interesting activity. Complete that activity and let me know what did you conclude from, what are your concluding points from that activity. So these similarities. So according to Mendel, the traits like color of the seed, seed coat and length of the stem, etc. are the hereditary characteristics that passes from parents to offsprings of the children. And this is called hereditary. Okay, the process in which the traits are passed from one generation to another generation, you called it inheritance. Okay. F1 generation, he's called it hereditary. Whereas if it is carried from your grandparents to the grandchildren, then you call it inheritance. Okay. So how do these traits expressed? So Mendel hypothesized that each character of the trait is expressed due to a pair of factors or alleles. Who are those alleles? As they were named. So they were known as genes. So you have got alleles. There is always a pair, so pair of genes that are available in a DNA. And this pair, he named them as alleles. And what he did is, due to this, he expressed that a pair of factors, and he named these factors as genes. Okay, so what he is, according to him, there are two types of sex chromosomes in human beings. One is X and another is Y. Females have got two X chromosomes whereas men has got one X and one Y chromosome. So, and one Y chromosome is XY in men and XX is female. So the gametes produced by man will be I have two types. Either it could be X or Y. Whereas a woman can produce only one chromosome, that is X. So supposing a woman share one X, her genes, one X chromosome, and man shares his X chromosomes, then the next generation would be a girl. Whereas if a woman, though, she gives X only, and if the man shares Y chromosome, then that will be a boy, baby boy. So the factor, so the baby will be a boy, and the gametes produced by the male is the deciding factor for the sex. That is what is important. It is the father who is who plays an important vital key role in having the daughter or a son. So various variations develop during reproduction in the organism. So let us do an activity to see what do you mean by variations. For example, if you look at the beetle leaves, paan ka patta jo hota hai na. So what was happening is, let us consider a group of 12 beetles. They live on the bushes on the green leaves, and their population started growing. So they were beetle, they were red in color. So what was happening is the crows, whenever the crows see it sitting on the green color, they would come and eat off. It was very obvious. They can easily see a red colored beetle, the insect on the green leaf. In this situation, a color variation arises during reproduction, so that there appears one beetle that is green in color instead of red. So what happened was, one beetle, there was a variation. So out of protection, the variation, natural variation took place, where, you know, they started having green colored beetles. So these beetles, crows cannot see because leaves were also green, and even those insects were also green on the bushes. So crows couldn't eat them, but crows can see red beetles and eat them easily. So that's how, from the environment, slowly the red beetles disappeared and green beetles increased. So this variation of the color in the green is the survival advantage. It is the survival of the fittest. So in order to survive, the next generation has changed. And this has happened through the natural selection, and it was exerted by the crows. So that is how, this is called variations, how it occurs. So the more crows there are, the more red beetles would be eaten, and the more number of green beetles in the population or the environment increases. Thus, the natural selection is directing the evolution in the beetle population. It results in the adaptation in the beetle population to fit in their environmental better. So wherever the variations occur, it occurs due to the environmental changes. Then it is called as an evolution. In this situation, a color variation occurs again in its progeny during reproduction, but now the result is blue colored. So blue colored progeny, so that all its progeny started growing blue. So now this green beetle changed to blue. So now blue also become very easy for the crow to detect, and they started eating it. Therefore, the crows can eat both red and blue colored beetles. So in order to survive, the green beetles becomes the fittest one to survive. In this case, no survival advantage for blue colored beetles, as we have seen in case of green colored beetles. Thus, you know, what happened initially in the population, there are very few blue beetles, but most are red. Imagine at this point, an elephant, you can just see an elephant while going, if it has come and gone away like this. So they killed, and then the chance of survival of mostly blue. Blue could survive, and most of the red beetles were dead. So again, the beetle population slowly increased, but in beetle population, most of them were blue in color, because by natural calamity, red has been disappeared. Thus, sometimes accidents may also be the results of the characteristics of the population. Characters are known, they are governed by the genes. Thus, there is a change in the frequency of genes in small population, and this is called as genetic drift, which provides diversity in the population. We see the diversity in the population because of this genetic drift. In this case, beetle population is increasing, but suddenly bushes were affected by the plant disease, in which leaf materials were destroyed, or in which leaves have been changed, affected by these beetles, and they got less food material. So beetles are poorly nourished. The weight of the beetles started decreasing because there was no proper nourishment for them. There was no change in the genetic material. And after a few years, the plant diseases are eliminated and bushes are healthy with the plenty of leaves on it, because there were no beetles to eat away the food of the leaves. So there were no changes in the place in the genetic material. After a few years, the plant diseases are eliminated. Bushes are healthy with plenty of leaves, as you can see here. Okay, and so this is how, you know, you could see how does this population of beetles reduce, and it's called variation, and what is genetic drift and evolution takes place. So complete this chapter and get back to it. I know this is not very easy. You need to do all the activities to understand it. And then please ask me wherever you have the doubts and get it clarified. It's very interesting for you to, so that it helps us to understand the next lesson easily. So take care till then. Be safe. The second wave of COVID is supposed to be very dangerous. So do take all the precautions, and at the same time, keep yourself positively engaged, prepare for the exams, and wherever you have doubts, feel free to ask. We are ready to give you all individual attention. Thank you. Take care. Allah Hafiz.